Caribbean.
Yeah.
It's nuts. And after the storm, we saw a lot of changes, especially when it came to homes and businesses. And there were concerns that it would probably have a negative impact on our housing market. We have the expert in to really delve into that. April Lee Osborne joining us this morning with more on how the market actually is looking 365 days outside of the storm. And April Lee, always a pleasure to have you in studio.
It's such an honor to be here.
Yeah, thanks so much for joining us.
It's really a heartfelt moment today. You know, I don't know if you feel that like sense of like...
Yeah.
Yeah. It's like we lost thousands of properties, you know, and I was thinking about it today. Like people, not only did they lose their properties and if people lost their lives, they lost like family heirlooms,
Sure. You
know, pictures of their kids when they were babies. It's like, I just always want to take a memory of that. Cause when you think of home, you think about those things too, you know? And so my heart just goes out for those families that lost everything, you know, and those things can't be replaced. You can buy a new house, but you can't buy new baby photos stuff like that, you know?
But
the market has definitely shifted. We've seen, I believe, some excitement going on in the market. You've got a lot of new developments. Everything is going to be new and fresh. Obviously, we lost hundreds of homes on along Fort Myers Beach and along our waterways. There was thousands that were completely damaged. And so when you look at that, that means everything's getting new.
Mm-hmm.
And so there's some excitement about new. Obviously, along our beaches, I feel like everything is getting a facelift. You know, so we do have more inventory right now than we've ever had, because obviously we've got some higher interest rates, you know, that's causing an effect on our market. And so it is absolutely a buyer's market at this moment. You can really get some good deals out there at this moment. So, you know, that's kind of what's going on right now in our market.
Did you see a trend of people coming in to buy more property following the storm?
You know, it's like there was this talk, you remember, like when we talked about like, is the waterfront properties going to tank because nobody wants to buy on the water? And I think there was like a moment of that was going on, you know, but it's just like people are just returning. I love how our culture is, everybody's like, we're here to boat, we're here to be on the beach, you know, and so yes, there is absolutely people still coming in, and they're still flocking in. Are you seeing the snowbird cars come in early?
Yeah. Oh gosh, I mean, it's like they're not leaving anymore.
No,
it's incredible.
It's absolutely incredible. So yes, they're absolutely here buying. They're here to buy. It didn't slow down our market that way.
Not at all. I know that our property took on significant damage from Ian,
because
we live down by the beach. But I was surprised as the owner of the property that to see that our value actually wasn't impacted as badly as I was anticipating. And to be perfectly honest with you, it started to go up just in the last several months. Is that a surprise?
You know, I think people do have that thought process. This is a surprise that this went up. But think about it. You get a new roof, new AC, new pool equipment, new flooring, sometimes new cabinets, depending how much water. So the house is like brand new, you know, and our governor called this the 500-year storm. And I really believe that. It's really probably that 500-year storm. So it's like that property just got new. And so when anything gets replaced and it's brand new, that brings increase of value.
And if people are looking to make a change to buy another property, should they be fearful of where interest rates are right now? Because they have been kind of at 20-year highs.
They are. They are absolutely high. And I'm like, come on, feds, let's take it down, take it down, take it down.
A little bit.
Just a little bit. Yeah, this is causing an impact on people. But I'm finding a lot of families are just shifting the way they do their personal lives.
Sure.
They might buy a cheaper home. Like I had a family the other day, what they could buy, say 2 years ago, it was $300,000 less they needed to spend for the same exact payment.
Mm.
And that was a big jump, $300,000 off your house. And so what they decided was, well, this is not my forever home. I'm gonna buy this cheaper home to keep my payment in the place that they want it to be. And we'll just keep it, fix it up, and then when those interest rates go back down, as we all know that's going to happen, that we're going to sell it, because what happens when the interest rates go down? The houses go up.
Mm-hmm.
And so they'll make a profit and then go buy the house that they wanted, and it's just like a 1 year, 2 year plan.
Now, are there pros and cons to having, as you said just a moment ago, a larger inventory?
Yeah, it is a little bit of a negative, you know, but even before the storm, I don't think it's storm related.
Mm-hmm.
If you go all the way back to COVID days, when people began to shift the way that they do home because they're at home more,
sure.
You know, and so that is really when we saw the inventory shortage go down dramatically. We had this, you know, bidding wars mm-hmm. and all that was going on, right? So we're seeing the highest level of inventory that we've had since those days. But so we've had these two major events that are not normal,
right.
Like COVID lockdowns was not normal.
Right.
You know, this storm was not normal. So we have all of a sudden, I think the market's trying to adjust and like, where's normal again? We're looking for normal again.
Two extremes, almost back to back.
Two major extremes, yeah. You know, and people don't think about it and talk about those extremes, but those are two major extremes. And so I think even like people, I had a family the other day, he was like, I have the choice to work from home and I have the choice to go to work. What do I want to do? And I think there's even that thought process for people that have moved here from other states and other areas that they can work from home, and but now they have the option to go back to work. Like, are they going to go back to that area?
Yeah,
you know,
right.
It's like those are the conversations that I'm having in the car with the real clients.
In your experience, though, what has surprised you most about the housing market after an event like Hurricane Ian, when you see all of this significant property damage?
You know, it's really just, it just shows how amazing that we just boom back and how community comes around our neighbors. I really love it how, like, I just saw people take off their hats and they became a neighbor, you know, whatever, yeah. You know. And so because of the heart of people and people just wanting to live life in peace and harmony and excitement and, like, we, here in Florida, we get to enjoy being outside like what 300 days a year probably.
Perfect.
And so it's like people just are excited to get back to that place. And so I just am so hopeful, and I've always seen that after the storm, like the first 30 days we were all in survival mode,
right?
You know, and so
a
lot of just what are we going to have? What's happening from here?
Mm-hmm.
But I'm seeing people excited to get back into those types of properties. They're excited to get back on the water, you know, and they're already on the water.
Oh, sure.
Yeah, you know, those boats are out there, you know.
So you're feeling pretty hopeful.
I feel great.
From here on out with the housing market.
I really am. I'm super excited, and I mean, I'm not worried about it.
Yeah. What's your advice for people who are currently looking right now? Because at this point in time, if, say, somebody like me is looking to sell, I could make a profit. A lot of people watching right now looking to sell can make a profit. So if they're looking to upgrade and move elsewhere here in Southwest Florida, what would you say to them?
I would recommend, if you're looking to sell right now, you want to, we're coming into the holiday season.
Mm-hmm.
You know, people are thinking about the holidays. Where are we going to do for Thanksgiving? Who's coming in for Christmas and those things? I would consider, unless you have to sell, I would maybe do it in January.
Okay.
And I would talk to a professional about exactly what that house is worth, because we do have a lot of people that still have a little bit of a vain imagination mm-hmm. that's going on that one number is not the real number. And so we need to make sure that we're getting our actual numbers. Let's do the math. You know, math never lies.
Sure.
And so do the math on that. And then also finding a real estate agent that will go to bat for you. That is the key. Because I talked to a buyer the other day. I'm like, you could have got 20 grand off of that house. What were you doing? You know?
Yeah.
And it's like, you want to find that that agent that listens to your family needs, because right now's the time to negotiate. This is the time to use the fact, and you could be paying cash,
mm-hmm.
but we can use the leverage that the interest rates are a little bit higher. You know, there's, you know, less buyers that can afford in this market. And we use that to negotiate to get a good deal. And so, you know, it's find the right agent to do it.
The deals are there.
The deals are absolutely there.
If people want information on Call It Close Realty, what do they need to know?
Yeah, call me directly at 239-220-8607. I would be honored to help you. I love serving our community.
Cool. It's always good to talk with you. Jen always steals the thunder.
I know.
I
we
get
never
to
get to talk.
I like it.
I love it.
It.
Yeah,
thanks for coming
it's amazing.
In. All right, we got to take a break. We're going to be right back in a minute.